Our goal is to address the three A's that I always talk about, which is the awareness, access and affordability. That will help women, especially in their periods when they need that help. If there's elder care or child care, which are usually the two reasons why women leave the workforce. So during those very stressful times, if they have mentors who handhold them, help them survive that phase.
Hi ma'am, this is Vaishnavi from AdGully. Could you take us through your journey at the helm of Emcure Pharma?
It's been a very exciting journey. I initially started as a chief financial officer. Was a CFO for quite a few years, and I started doing balance sheet in my head and needed something a little different, more exciting, which is when I took over the India business, the domestic business, and that's an area I'm very passionate about, very excited about, especially working around women's health. Very happy to know your sister uses Galax. Thank you for that. So that's been the journey so far. And now with the IPO, even more exciting times ahead.
Yeah, so Emcure is set for the IPOs in July. So how much are you expecting to raise from the market, and what would the funds raise prominent spend off on?
So we're getting about 800 crore primary, essentially for paying down our debt and corporate purposes.
Okay.
And you know, the remaining is a secondary offering. And this is something that is slated between 3rd and 5th of July. So looking forward to that.
So investors are, for investors starting at 3rd July. Yeah, okay. So how has Emcure Pharma been like in FY 2024? And what are your growth target as well as for areas in FY 2025?
So 2024, all the data is in DRHP in terms of, you know, sales 6658, an EBIT of 19%, very diversified in terms of geography, 70 plus countries. You know, obviously we can't give any forward looking numbers at this point, but this is a company that's one to watch out for, poised for very good growth both in the domestic and the global areas.
Yeah, so what are your views on the current state of overall pharma industry in India?
Unfortunately, people have bad lifestyles, and you know, especially the NCDs, non-communicable diseases, the chronic sector is really getting worse by the day. Our goal is to address the three A's that I always talk about, which is the awareness, access and affordability. So if Emcure can really help in these areas in providing top-notch drugs at affordable prices, it's an exciting sector to be in, and we hope to do justice in terms of what we provide to the end consumer.
Absolutely. So you have been a judge on Shark Tank, we all know. What where you have met several budding entrepreneurs, and do you believe the show has been able to empower entrepreneurial ventures?
Absolutely. So, you know, when I go to airports, there's all the way from an 8-year-old child to an 80-year-old grandmom who come to me, and they're talking EBITDA and, you know, cost of acquisition and equity. And it's wonderful to see that, because I always say that what I learned in business school, this show is teaching through storytelling to the masses, and we're celebrating the startup ecosystem, which is so fabulous.
Yeah. So how do you view the startup ecosystem again? Has it been able to keep up with the growth momentums?
Absolutely. So, you know, India is a very vibrant startup ecosystem. In fact, Emcure is a shining example of entrepreneurship.
Yes.
And that's the reason why I joined Shark Tank, because at some point when you get so much, you have this desire to give back. And that's why I joined the show. But I must say that I thought, like, I teach a few things to founders, but I've learned a lot more than I've taught. It's just been inspiring. It's been fantastic to see the quality of founders and ideas that our country has to offer to the world.
Yeah. So what are your experiences as a woman business leader in today's marketing ecosystem?
I think we definitely need more women representation in the workforce, and definitely more on boards. For sure, more in leadership positions. But I'm an optimist. I see things a lot better than where they were 10 years back.
Yeah.
Look at young, you know, very smart women like you. Definitely a lot of work is needed, but we're headed in the right direction.
Okay. So, do you think women leaders in India still need to go to the extra mile to prove their battles vice versa the male counterparts?
I think there are stereotypes, but instead of sitting and talking about those stereotypes, if we just divert that amount of time and energy to producing our numbers,
yes, absolutely,
we'll shut everybody up.
Yeah. So let's we should not just not talk about it.
I mean, we
should just
we
work
can talk
about it.
About certain things to highlight and break certain taboos. Like, for example, in women's health, I run this YouTube channel called Uncondition Yourself, where I speak on a lot of health issues, which and it's important to speak about those women's health issues because there's still women suffering in silence because of the taboos.
Yeah.
So of course their speaking up is important, but when it comes to my work and my business, I think my numbers should say whatever there is to say.
Yeah, absolutely. What can organization do to nurture the next generation of women business leadership? What NCOF policy is this regards?
I think for me, my mentors have played a very big role in shaping who I am. So if more companies have mentors, and not just women, male mentors and champions as well, that will help women, especially in their periods when they need that help. If there's elder care or child care, which are usually the two reasons why women leave the workforce. So during those very stressful times, if they have mentors who handhold them, help them survive that phase through flexible working arrangements, through kind of just being there for them, we'll have a lot fewer women dropping out of the workforce. So that is something that we do. So at MQO, we have a women's program called Prerna, Inspiration, where all the women get together and we have only women speakers. We have a lot of mentoring opportunities. So I think these programs definitely help in building a community of sisterhood where women feel... you know, good about supporting and celebrating each other.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you for your time, ma'am.